Dodge in the driveway. An explosion seriously burns two Boy Scouts, hurts two other teens and two adults. We're learning today it was a gunpowder mixture designed for effect, not harm. And we've learned this evening both Scouts burned most seriously are in good condition. Good evening. I'm Jeremy Maskell.
I'm Melissa Fry. Investigators say adults were mixing gunpowder to be used in an honor society ceremony for Boy Scouts. But Thursday evening in a home near Mall of the Bluffs, the pot of gunpowder exploded as Scouts carried it outside to test.
KETV News Watch 7's Tony Cornett updates the investigation in our big story at 6. Tony?
The Scouts call it an unfortunate accident. Sources tell us the adults in the Council Bluffs home had made this gunpowder mixture several times before, but last night during a test run, something went terribly wrong and Scouts got hurt. Checking the internet for video of Order of the Arrow ceremonies, you find several examples where fire is used, like here in Las Vegas. Sources tell us inside this home Thursday night, Scout leaders and four Scouts were using gunpowder and possibly other compounds to develop some sort of effect for just such a ceremony.
It does not look like the kids were playing in the basement with explosives.
And we're told it's something the adults had done before. The six were carrying a pot of the mixture outside to test it. Instead, it exploded inside the house. Cuts and serious second-degree burns are the result. Investigator Dan Roberts says this is dangerous from the start.
This should never be done at home. You need to be a professional to be dealing with anything in pyrotechnics or explosives or anything like that. You should not be conducting any kind of fire experiments at home.
Neighbors say they heard a pair of explosions. The injured ran out front where Scouts Jared Holcomb and Scott Brown needed the most attention. Holcomb has second-degree burns, but he and Brown are in good condition. One unidentified adult is still hospitalized.
There are specific laws, specific safety practices that need to be taken. They need to be done in certain places, things like that.
Now to that very point, Pottawatomie County Attorney Matt Wilbur told us medical concerns are most important right now, and he needs complete investigation reports before deciding whether any Iowa laws were broken. And an ATF spokesman told us this afternoon that the Scouts' homemade special effects mixture doesn't appear to run afoul of any federal law and just called it a terrible accident. Jeremy?
All right, Tony Cornett live in the Newsplex. Tony, thanks. And we reached out this afternoon to the Mid-America Council of the Boy Scouts.
Yeah, the spokesperson says the group is extremely saddened by the accident. In a statement, the Boy Scouts chapter says, when appropriate, we will carefully review the situation to see if there are any safety enhancements that may be necessary. The Scouts most seriously burned in the accident are both students at Abraham Lincoln High School. Today, we talked to a couple of their friends.
Jared's going through a really tough time already, so it's scary. I mean, knowing two kids from our school that got in this incident, but we know they'll get through it.
Yeah, Jared Holcomb's father, Michael, died just over 3 weeks ago. He was hit by a semi-truck on Interstate 80 after his Jeep stalled. Again, both Scouts, Scott Brown and Jared Holcomb, are in good condition at a Lincoln Hospital burn center.